Hello and welcome to Bivvy TV News. I'm Roberta and I'm here with your weekly roundup of news and catches. This week's top story, Bivvy TV presenter Rob Marsh has caught the largest UK carp of the year from Elphick's North Lake. The big girl weighed in at a massive 60 pounds and 6 ounces, smashing Rob's previous UK PB by almost 10 pounds. He caught her using a 3-pound high S rod, 10-pound Ultima Power carp line, atomic bombs away safety clip setup with tungsten tubing and a 2-ounce gravel swivel lead.
Still 60 pounds, 6 ounces. It's a new PB. It's a new lake record.
Rob told us, "I am still simply gobsmacked at catching such a large fish in the UK, and I'm very pleased to beat my long-standing PB of 50 pounds, 15 ounces.
Right.
See a load of fish.
Well, it's absolutely fantastic. She wants to go. Come on, you big girl. Get in there!
Well done, Rob. Fellow Bivvy TV presenter Alan Taylor caught this amazing 80-pound, 4-ounce monster from Rainbow Lakes last week.
Have some.
Amazing, mate.
Big.
Alan was over the moon with this beautiful catch, and when we asked him how he was feeling, he simply said, "Happy days." Nice one, Alan. A few weeks ago, Lee Jackson and Ian Chilcott won the 2011 World Carp Angling Championships. We caught up with Lee over the weekend to find out more about his dramatic win.
So Lee, what do you think set you apart from the other teams, and what did you do differently to everyone else? What did you change? What did you do as you normally do that led to you having such a dramatic win in America?
Well, I think first and foremost, we wasn't in a particularly favoured swim. I mean, 2 days before the match started, which was held over a 35-mile stretch of the St Lawrence, we went out in a boat and had an underwater camera. We had a look at most of the swims through the underwater camera. I mean, this camera really was the business. Like, yeah, you could see it's like shells on the bottom and everything, you know. And funnily enough, the area that I really fancied, which was my top choice, was the swim that myself and Martin Lockfist did in 2005. That would have been our top choice. And the actual area where we ended up fishing, it didn't really look a favourable area at all. Plus the fact it was a centre peg, which is always a bad position to be in. But I must admit, at first we struggled a little bit with it. You know, we did sort of struggle. I mean, we was in a shipping lane. It was around about 250 yards wide, with these whacking great container ships coming through there, like 4 or 5 times a day or night. You know, and when these container ships come through, it has the effect of like sucking the water down, and obviously eventually wiping out your rods. You know, so you have to recast fairly regular, which is a bit of a pain in the middle of the night. I think where we scored, I mean, we worked out how to bait it correctly. I mean, the flow of the river was going left, the bottom current was going from left to right. Well, the guys to our left, which was about 100 yards away from our left, they was baiting up fairly much in front of themselves, you know. So consequently, like most of their bait was probably, I'm only guessing here, was ended up in front of us. We was baiting to our extreme left, so hopefully our bait was ending up in front of us as well. And because these ships have the effect of sort of sucking the water in, every time we saw a ship approaching, and it was usually me, I would run as far as I could on, to be left with a great big bucket of bait and just throw it in underarm, like just in the water. So when the boat comes through, it sucks out into the river, goes down to where we're fishing again. And I think in the finish, the fish just knew where there was food, you know. There was always food, and I mean the St Lawrence carps swim around in massive great shoals, and I think when they came through they just made a beeline for our swim, because the lads either side, you know, just didn't do anywhere near as good, like, you know. And I think another thing that sort of we scored was determination. I mean, we had a total of seven hours sleep in 151 hours, which is pretty you know, I mean, I must admit, it was, you know, it's quite tiring to say the least, and the discomfort of it all as well. You know, I mean, because it was a rocky terrain, we had to wear shorts all the time because there was a ledge, so we had to get the water to play fish to get them over this ledge. There were these little black fly things that they'd land on you, and before you could swat them, they sort of stung you and drew blood, and like, you know, and they were fairly uncomfortable. And after a few days of it, I mean, by about 3 days, we were sort of really getting on top of it, you know, really sort of sorted it out. And but by this time, our backs were aching. You know, we were both 50-year-old men, like, you know, 50 year plus, and backs were aching, our bite on bite and everything really was uncomfortable. Like, you know, the thing that really sort of stands out to me was the last evening. And this really sort of shows you the determination we had. Last evening, it absolutely poured with rain. We got absolutely soaked with the skin. Like, I remember sitting there under my umbrella, flies all over me, bitten to bit, back aching and everything. And I thought, this really is not, you know, good. You know, not sort of fun anymore. And I turned out the Chilean, but we knew there was an American pair doing quite well. You know, and we didn't quite know. We knew we was in the lead, but we didn't know, you know, how much in the lead. So I said to Chile, like Ian Chilcott, I said, our best thing is to go to bed now, get in the sleeping bag now, 10 o'clock at night. We'll have 2 hours sleep and we'll get up at midnight and then go for it to the end. And that's what we did. I mean, I must admit, when the alarm went off at midnight, having only had two, like, wet, uncomfortable sort of hours sleep, like, you know, I really didn't want to get up. I got out there, so I forced myself to get up and recast, put a couple of spotfuls of bait and had a bite almost straight away, and then it was about 15 minutes before I could wake Chilly up, because he was in such a deep sleep. And but eventually he got up, and we just went for it to the end. And I think it's adrenaline that really kept us going. But I think the main reason I think we won was, you know, we really worked it out, baited it well, and it was determination in the end. You know, adrenaline. You know, you just sort of, you can see the end is near, and you can see the prize is there, and you just go for it.
Okay. And how's it feel to now be one of a pair of world champions?
It's quite a prayer. I mean, people say, I mean, you're not the best carp angler in the world, but, you know, by long, but everyone's free to go in that competition, and we aim to sort of win it. So, you know, until the next one, we are world champions, and it's quite sort of, yeah, it's quite a proud sort of, quite a good thing to add to your CV, you know.
So it's been quite a good and positive year for you. I mean, catching the World Cup Classic with...
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Cool. Yeah.
And then now world champions.
Yes, right.
Is there anything that you want to say to, you know, any of your sponsors or anyone?
I'd like to thank first and foremost, like, Gary and Kevin from the Tackle Box, who I mainly work for. Thank them for letting me have the time off, if you like. And I'd like to sponsor the event. First and foremost, most carp world, and there's tackle sponsors were Fox and bait was Mainline. I'd like to thank all those, and I'd like to thank Jerry and Marcy at Carp Angling Adventures for sort of making us all welcome during our stay.
Alright, thanks then.
Yeah. Cheers.
This weekend, Budapest hosts the world famous Ponty Show from Friday the 11th to Sunday the 13th of November. ViviTV will be there as an official media partner, and we will be bringing you coverage and interviews from the show. So even if you can't be there, you won't miss out. In other news, Carping for Cancer held an event last week at Orchid Lakes in Oxfordshire, where they managed to raise over £9,000 for charity. A truly fantastic result. Whilst out on a Halloween fishing trip in the Isle of Wight, Brandon caught this 8.5-pound common, and his friend Charlie caught this lovely fish weighing in at 22 pounds, 8 ounces. Catch of the week goes to Nicholas Holzer from Italy, who caught this stunning 60 pounds, 6 ounce mirror from a water in Eastern Europe, using the new Ultima Power Carp XR 14 pound line and Frank Warwick's fruit smoothie bait. Grande risottato, Nicholas! And finally, ViviTV regulars Jack Shirity and Tom Barge have both made impressive catches from Drayton Reservoir this week. Jack caught this 21-pound 7-ounce beauty on jungle boilies over a spod mix of hemp pellets and earthworm liquid, and Tom's catch weighed in at a very impressive 23 pounds, which he also caught using jungle boilies. Great stuff, guys. That's all for this week. I'll be back next week with more news and catch reports. In the meantime, you can follow the news as it happens on Facebook and Twitter. Just search Bivvy TV. Don't forget to check out our website, www.bivvy.tv, where you can check out all our videos, all for free. Also, if you've got a news story you think we should know about, would like to send me a message, a picture you relate as catch, or even a press release, simply email newsdesk@bivvy.tv. Catch you next week.